Hello, Mr. Anujas, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. And here I am presenting to you exposition of Luke 10, verse 21 to 24. At that same hour, Jesus rejoiced in the Holy Spirit and said, I thank you, Father, and not Lord of heaven and earth, Lord of natural heaven and earth that you can see with your two naked eyes. So, is of the Creator demiurge Yahweh. It's all belong to Yahweh, which you can see. Nature, natural man, is produced by Yahweh. Because you have hidden these things from the worldly, wise, clever hypocrites. As today you have politicians who make sugar-coated speeches of falsehoods, and are these hireling dog-collared priests in the churches, which are the replacement of the temple rabbis, who are Judas Iscariots in sheep's clothing, working for Mammon rather than God, and the intelligent, and have revealed to them to infants. Infants mean people with unbiased heart, as clean as the water. Jesus asked the workers in Cana to fill the jars with, when he turned water, the minds of infants or little children into the new wine beyond the human wisdom. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. I am putting my own interpretation in there, you know, so you will find the text a little bit confusing. You have to bear with me. All things have been handed over to me, because he had the Christ. Christ stands for his word, and his word was in the beginning, before the creation of even Yahweh. So he was before Yahweh, before David, and everything. That's what confused those people in the temple. Even the Pharisee over there could not understand or could not answer when he asked them, whose son is Messiah? They could not tell him. They could not answer that. Today, in the churches, you see in the Nicene Creed, they say Christ died, Christ rose on third day. Christ stands for his word. Or Messiah. Messiah is forever. It's written in the Bible, everything, but these blind, spiritually blind professors in the universities, I call them super donkeys carrying holy books. So they can't understand this gospel. That's what Jesus means from the worldly wise people. They get degrees in their hand, you know, PhD, doctor of theology, this and that. If you ask them what Yeshua stands for, what Yeshua means, you know, they have no idea. And none of you will know it unless our Father giveth. Yeshua is from made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shua mean Adam. The firstborn of Yahweh, second Adam. And I put videos on this one. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will, all things have been handed over to me, the Christ, his anointed son, by my Father. And no one knows who the Son is except the Father. Our praises don't lie with the men. Our praises lie with our Father who gave us this word by grace. So people seeking, you know, the praises of men, they are psychic. Like Billy Graham and other things, engaging people in prayers and fasting. Prayer, what prayer has to do with God? Our God is spirit. We only understand His word, His language. Not prayer is the language of Yahweh, demiurge God. Children used to say it. We are not children once born, we are twice born. When Jesus was the disciple of John the Baptist, then he said prayer and fasting for 40 days. After that, when he started his own ministry, no more prayer or fasting. But when Jesus was sitting at Matthew's place, some Pharisees, Lucy came, "Hey, your disciples, they don't wash their hands, they don't say prayer, no fasting." Jesus said, "When so far the bridegroom, Christ, is in my heart, in their heart, they don't need to do it. When Christ is gone and the dead letters have gone into their head as they read the Bible in the churches and other things, then they will say prayer and fasting." That's what they do in churches today. They are all become super donkeys carrying holy books. Or who the Father is, except the Son, whilst the others call Him Lord. The sons call Him Father. The once-born people call Him Lord. Lord has slaves, disciples, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal Him, as He did to Peter, to give him a taste or glimpse of gospel. But he became arrogant and lacking the Holy Spirit, common sense, because he was once born. He started to rebuke Jesus as he mentioned what will happen to him in Jerusalem. When Jesus said, "They will beat me, they will do this thing, that thing to me, and they will kill me." Peter said, "Hey, how can they kill you? You make the dead people alive. How can they kill you?" That he knew had the sense of spirit of men. What men see, natural eyes, not the third eye of logical reasoning. Then turning to the friends and not the disciple, the root of the word disciple is discipline. The rabbis and Pharisees, Sadducees, they disciplined their natural men through moral laws of Moses. Jesus said to them privately, because they belong to the inner circle of heart, outer circle of this one. 70 outer circle was concerned with this one. Our Christ Jesus and his labor was concerned with heart. So none of them baptized anyone in water. Jesus or his laborers, but the 70 outer circle laborers, they baptized people in the name of Abraham. They used to go in pairs. So because they belong to the inner circle, to be kept invisible as our soul is in relation to the outer 70 laborers being trained for the ministry of John the Baptist. They used to go in pairs ahead of Jesus, preparing the way by baptizing the Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham. Blessed. So Abraham, Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist. John the Baptist baptized Jesus in the name of Yahweh. And he himself, John the Baptist, prophet Elijah. Elijah stands for "My God is Yahweh." And prophet Elijah, John the Baptist, he was working for Yahweh. And he was the himself, Yahweh came in front of him in the form of Jesus, Yeshua. So blessed, he baptized Jesus in the name of Yahweh, not in the name of Abraham. Blessed are the eyes that see the miraculous power of our supernatural Father God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, or what you see with your two naked eye is the supernatural power, feeding the 5,000, stopping the storm, and healing the sick people, and all that, through the power of supernatural Father. Their own belief, own faith healed them. For I tell you that many prophets witnessed to the light. Prophets are witnessed to the light, but not the light, as John the Baptist was, like moon, you know, their moon. And Christ Jesus is sun, the primary source of light. As the John the Baptist was, and clean-hearted kings like David of Judah tribe desired to see what you see, but did not see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it, because the rabbis were efficient, and darkness had not overcome the natural truth. So, you know, when they are efficient and they have the knowledge of oral Torah gives you the root of this gospel. Gospel is like a tree. The moral laws are like tree. The root of the tree you can't see. And that is oral Torah, or his word, gospel. So gospel is the root of the moral laws. At that time they had the gospel, and they had the root, and they were efficient. But as the greed came, gospel gone, and dead letters were there. They were applying dead letters for their living. So hope this will make sense, and our Father God blesses you.